done with sports talk worldwide with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, no sunshine in the house, right? Hey, I told you I wasn't going to watch the Canelo Alvarez Admiral YILDIRIM fight. And from what I hear, you know, it was a farce. The dude just stood there and let himself get beat up. You know, round three stoppage. Didn't come out, something. So I got to watch it to find out. But I read, you know, a little something. You know, round three of the fight was over and the dude didn't basically fight back. Right? Interesting enough, I'm hearing that Canelo got around $10 million for this. That's a far cry from $35 million that he could have got for fighting a Demetrius Andrade, a Charlo, a Benavidez, or a Beterbiev. Right? So that's a far cry. So all those things when we're looking at him getting out his DAZN contract because they wanted him to fight premium opponents, YILDIRIM ain't premium. And so that's cost him a lot of money, right, for fighting these kind of guys. This video is here just to remind people, right, because for those who watched it, because the commentators are not going to tell you this, right, but for those who watched that fight and all that stuff, and for those who see my last video to understand the guy's record, who he fought before, make sure it's clear. I keep repeating myself because I'm not going to edit this video. This is just going to come, you know, whatever. But in my other videos, I've had screenshots showing you. Canelo requested this opponent. Canelo called the WBC to make sure that he was able to fight this guy. Right? That's very, very clear and important that he called to have this opponent. Right? It's no one else. That was Canelo for doing that. And that, you know, makes you look at not only Canelo, but the WBC. Because you have to remember this. In 160 pounds, just last year when Charlo was Canelo's mandatory, Canelo recalled the WBC to ask them to do something so he doesn't have to fight this mandatory. And that's when the Charlo belt or the franchise belt was born. So that means he requested that too. So he's requesting a YILDIRIM fight in 168. He requested a new belt or something so he doesn't have to fight as mandatory. And then the WBC, let's make sure too that when he fought Callum Smith at 168, the WBC just put the WBC belt on the line, and that fight was for the WBA. That means we would rather have Canelo fight for the WBC title, but he just has it given to him from the WBC, who is just absolutely ridiculous. Now we have to put on top of that, remember Canelo couldn't make 154 pounds anymore, and he didn't really want to go to 160 yet, and they let him fight at, what do we call it, Canelo weight at 155 pounds. That was also three or four fights. That's enabling. We got a weight division at 154, and we got one at 160. Yeah, it's only 6 pounds apart. Can't you make one of them? Nope. No one's saying anything about that, right? Then make sure something else is clear, right? When Canelo got popped dirty for Combuterol twice, the WBC raises the level of Combuterol that you're allowed to take, okay? This is a lot of stuff that's going for Canelo's way. And let's make some other stuff clear. You know, back when it was WBO, as soon as Demetrius Andrade got stripped at 154, in comes Leon Smith. What happens? Canelo fights Leon Smith. He didn't fight Demetrius when he had the title and Demetrius called him out, right? So as soon as Benavidez gets stripped at 168 pounds, then he comes in to fight YILDIRIM and the WBC gives him the title instead of saying, okay, well, what we're going to do is have you fight Benavidez because Benavidez missed it as soon as COVID started, right? He missed weight. I don't think we're going to strip him, but we will give you the opportunity to fight Benavidez. So basically, Canelo is making these damn calls, right? That's the problem here. You got a fighter making calls, and fighters are now talking smack. People that are mandatories, like the mandatory here, Ryan Garcia. He's up here telling people he's a mandatory to fight Devin Haney. But he, as the mandatory, is telling Devin Haney, and Devin Haney's the champion. The champion hasn't done enough to fight me, right? And you just had a fight with Luke Campbell to fight Devin Haney. Beats Luke Campbell, now telling Devin Haney he hasn't done nothing as a champion. Man, you know, look, boxing is getting to be really just blatant. But it's blatant everything we're doing. But make sure this is clear. Canelo got away with calling this guy to fight a YILDIRIM. And when you're looking at what I keep talking about every time I talk about Canelo is Demetrius Andrade and or Charlo. If he were to fight either one of those guys, right? Now, I'm not a time traveler, or nothing like that, right? But I'm telling you what's going to happen if he did. If he fought Charlo or Andre, when he has his ring walk, and the other one's already in there because Canelo's going to be the A-side, right? So the other one's already in the ring. When Canelo is walking to the ring, this is what they're going to say. Canelo Alvarez on his way to the ring in what could be his hardest fight to date. That's what they're going to say. And then the other commentator is going to interrupt him and say, excuse me, it is his hardest fight to date, right? If it's Andre or Charlo, say, the one commentator is going to say it could be his hardest fight to date, and the other one going to interrupt him and tell him it is the hardest fight to date, because either one of those guys would be Canelo's hardest fight to date for sure. Because who you got? It can't be Mayweather because he lost that one, but no one was scared of Mayweather knocking him out, right? And up until now, he hadn't fought nobody, which is, you know, who's going to be harder than a Charlo or an Andrade. And we know that. So, you know, and they're going to also be the second highest payday of his career. Because I don't know what he got with Floyd Mayweather. But it's going to probably be the second highest payday, if not the first highest payday. His most significant fight, especially for pound for pound, and his hardest fight with either one of those guys. Better be of as well. But that's not what's happening. So what we do, we call up the WBC and get an easy fight like Yildirim, and then we have a farce like we had. Is that what you guys want? Is that what your pound for pound is supposed to look like? Let's be real. Doma Sports Talk Worldwide. And I'm about to hit y'all.